Hey everyone, welcome to the studio. I'm Jamie Cassop, and this is Castro. Say hi, Castro. Since he was a puppy, he loves to be up on my desk. When the doors are open, he comes into my studio and scratches my leg because he wants to be up here, so I put him up here, and he's really good. He's been in lots of meetings. He's heard lots of discussions. That's Chico, and he does not like to sit up on the desk, but you know, every dog is different. And today, we are attending a couple meetings. There's a couple people in town that want to meet, talk about what they're doing and give them some advice. So I'm gonna go do that. And then I'm meeting a group of educators who are trying to get some big dollar funding from a project. They wanna pitch their pitch to me. They want to, before they go and actually have the meeting, they made it to the pitch round, they wanna go pitch this, and they want me to listen to it so I can give them some feedback. So that's what we're doing today. All right, Castro? Still nothing.
About to leave, already packing. Come with me, I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know.
Are you done? This is Chico. He's the insane dog. All he wants to do is play and run. Those are the only things that he wants to do. Today's episode is about two things that are related to each other. One is expertise, and the second one is karma and how those two things work well together. Because I believe that everyone's an expert in something. Whether you have been working for 2 years or 20 years or 40 years, whether whether it's work or a hobby that you believe in or that you're passionate about, and there's always someone who can learn from that expertise, right? That's why we watch YouTube videos. You have to ask, why would you want to do that? And that's where the second thing comes in, karma. The more you give, the more you get. You share and you get back, and that's how it works, and that's what today's about, so we're going to talk about that. All right, guys, let's go. Another beautiful day in Phoenix. One of the 200 reasons I live here. Right. Well, you should be going to more of those Texas events, right? January 29th or whatever it is the administrators conference, right? So they're all getting together in Austin, and you should be part of that. So I'm going to introduce you to Jada. This is Jada, and she runs a really interesting program in Texas.
Well, I'm Jada Batchelder. I am the founder and executive director of Education Open Stores. We are a Dallas-based nonprofit, and we work to train teachers so that they're able to equip students, particularly in middle school, with the knowledge and skills they need to begin to understand what their options are after high school and how do they access them. So our ultimate goal is that every student understands that path to two-year, four-year trade school, vocational school, and they're able to actually begin making those changes, taking those steps that it takes, beginning in middle school and throughout high school, so that they can make their future career aspirations a reality.
She's doing cool work. So the meeting with Jada went well. She's working with students to get them to start processing the idea of post-high school experience, right? Whether that's college or 2 years or certification, but she's getting kids as early as sixth grade thinking about that. So she's doing some amazing work. She's got to do more of it. She's got to expand what she's working on right now. She's just in Texas and she should be doing more. Why I like working with her is because she's really good at getting feedback. Oftentimes when someone asks you for feedback, what they're really asking for is validation. Can you validate this for me? Can you make me feel better about whatever decision is that I made or whatever thing I'm working on? And then if you give them feedback, they get upset. So first thing you gotta do as someone who's getting feedback is make sure that you are actually asking for feedback, that you're not just asking for validation. If you are someone who's providing feedback, you need to be really good at figuring out whether someone's asking you for real feedback or they're asking you for validation. So oftentimes they're asking you for validation. So make sure you know the difference. Anyway, on to my next meeting.
See you. How's it going?
Good, good. Welcome to our digs.
Thanks.
I have like a cool. Tiny fishbowl in the back, but we're going to be in the...
Isn't it pretty? This is awesome. I'm like, oh cool, she's gonna bring me a coffee mug and maybe there's a donation center I can donate somewhere, but this is actually really cool. All right, well good luck. Thank you, we appreciate it. Thank you, good luck. Let me know how it goes. Thank you, we better win. We gotta, thank you.
All right, thanks, man. All right, so much.
Thank you very much.
I like her shoes.
And I reviewed a pitch, gave him some feedback. Really cool project that they're working on. All right, let's get home. I hate getting gas. All right, that last meeting went well. I met with a team that is pitching an idea around how to increase FAFSA application completions in Arizona, in Phoenix. And there's an organization that's gonna provide $1 million of funding to one of 12 teams. This team was one of the finalists that are pitching their idea for $1 million project. And I was able to give them some feedback on their presentation. And hopefully that was helpful for them, and I can't wait to see how they do. So to sum up today, it's about expertise and karma. You are an expert in lots of things, and there are experts who know more than you. And you should be able to share your expertise with people who don't have the same expertise, and you should be able to ask experts for their advice or their feedback on whatever it is that you're working on. And the karma part of that is you do that, you get yourself out there and it'll come back to you. Whether it's the same people or it's other people, it goes both ways. Make sure that you are open for feedback. Again, not validation, feedback. Feedback that you can use. And it's this idea of always learning. We're gonna talk more about this idea, the ability to learn. And part of the ability to learn is to be open to feedback and using feedback to get better at whatever it is that you do. One of the strategies that I have that I wanna share with you guys is this idea of building a personal board of directors. So I have a board of directors. My wife is the president of the board. Whenever I wanna make a decision, whenever I have an idea, whenever I have a life decision to make, whether it's about my career, whether it's about work that I'm doing, whether it's about what do I do next, I go to this board and I ask for feedback. Not validation, actual feedback. And I created this board because I know they're gonna give me honest feedback. I know they're gonna give me something that I can use. So I encourage you to create your board of directors. So people that you can go to that you know are not gonna validate you. What they're doing is they're gonna be honest with you and they're gonna give you the right feedback. That's what today's about. Hopefully you guys got something out of it. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, the notification button, let other people know about this, and I will see you in the next video.